Welcome to the show. Now, first of all, I want to explain,
Mr. Benny.
I'll tell you how that happened. You know, as a rule, I make my entrance from that side of the stage, you see. And then when I walk out, I turn to the right to address the audience. Well, this time I happened to be standing on that side when they played my theme song. So when I walked out, by force of habit, I turned the wrong way, you know. Of course, it could happen to anybody. It could be because I'm very nervous. I'm really very nervous tonight because I have as my guest star the most popular and most exciting personality in show business today. You'll be thrilled when you see him. But first of all, I must do something. Oh, Don, please. It gives me great pleasure to present my guest star, Mr. Robert Goulet. On the way home, you can drop that off at my house.
Jack, drop it off yourself. And it's the last time I sign a contract without reading the fine print. I mean, other shows get Emmys. This one gets the good housekeeping seal of approval.
Robert, look, I hope you don't resent that entrance I gave you because, really, it was done for a laugh, just for a gag.
Jack, if it was just for a gag, why did you have me rehearsing at your house all week? Every day it was a different room.
Robert, look, the important thing is that you're here, right? Mm-hmm. I mean, my viewers, they're not interested how I have my rugs done or who does them. They're interested in your career, and they'd like to know more about you, I'm sure. Now, Bob, tell me, you were born in Canada, weren't you?
No, Jack, I was born in Lawrence, Massachusetts, but my family moved to Alberta in Canada when I was very young.
Oh, then you were brought up in Canada?
Yes.
In a large city?
No, actually, we were brought up on the edge of the wilderness, Jack, and sometimes months would go by before we'd see another human being.
That must have been lonesome.
Yes, it was. It was rather lonesome. But I must tell you, one day, we looked outside the cabin, and we saw footprints in the snow. And we followed the footprints. It was so exciting. Across the frozen lakes, and up and down the snow-bound hills, and across a big bend, and there he was, Jack, lying in the snow.
Who?
Nelson Eddy. Well, I went over to help him, and I almost ruined $1 million movie.
The director must have been pretty angry, wasn't he?
Oh, he was angry. What he was yelling at me wasn't the Indian love call.
Now, Bob, you've had a very colorful career, no question about it. And I thought you were wonderful in Camelot.
Thank you very much.
And I understand that since you left Broadway, you've been playing in nightclubs. Is
yes,
that right?
I've played quite a bit of nightclubs, Jack, and I like them very much.
You do? You know, I used to play nightclubs, but I stopped. I enjoyed them, too. But, I don't know, sometimes a drunk would get up, you know, right while I was entertaining, some drunk would get up and throw money on the stage.
Jack, they don't do that anymore.
I know. Those were the good old days, weren't they? I think now, instead of just standing out here and talking, I think our viewers would love to hear you sing. So how about it?
Well, I'd love to.
Okay.
Excuse me.
Yeah. smell on shag rugs. And now, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Robert Goulet will sing "This Is All I Ask."
As I approach the prime of my life, I find I have the time of my life. Learning to enjoy at my leisure all the simple pleasures. And so I happily concede. This is all I ask. Girls, walk a little slower when you walk by me. Lingering sunsets, stay a little longer with a lonely sea. Children everywhere, when you shoot at bad men, that strange, enchanted land. Grown-ups seldom understand wandering rainbows leave a bit of color for my heart to own. Stars in the sky make my wish come true before music play. As long as there's a song for me to sing, and I will stay younger.
Let me tell you something that happened. I don't think I ought to tell you. Yes, I'm going to tell you. Such a big lover. Let me tell you what happened. A few weeks ago, I happened to drop in to one of our more popular nightclubs here in Hollywood. While I was sitting there wondering what I should order, I happened to look across the room, and there was Robert Goulet with a very lovely girl. Ordinarily, I don't mix business with pleasure, but I had been thinking for a long time of asking Mr. Goulet to be on my show, and although this sort of thing is usually done through agents, I didn't see any harm in handling it as one star to another.
Pardon. Oh, we'll have two more martinis.
I'm not the waiter.
Jack, I'm sorry. I didn't recognize you in the dim light.
All right.
Jack, I want to meet Miss Diane Scott. Diane, this is Mr. Jack Benny.
How do you do?
Hello.
Bob, I didn't mean to interfere with your privacy, but the reason I came over here is I wanted to ask you if you'd like to be a guest on one of my television shows.
Oh, Jack, that I would love very much. Listen, why don't I check with my agent on my availability?
Yeah, I hope you can make it.
So do I.
That would be great, and we'll talk about it later.
Okay.
And forgive me again for this interruption.
Are you sitting by yourself?
Yes, I am.
Well, why don't you join us? Please.
Well, I... I wouldn't...
Oh, no, no, it's quite all right. Join us.
About this show you're speaking of, do you have any definite ideas in mind?
Well, naturally, Bob, you being on the show, they would want you to sing, you know, a couple of songs. And then, for a change of pace, it would be good if we did a kind of a comedy sketch, you know. I think that would be a good idea. Don't you, Miss Scott?
Call me Diane.
Now, as I was saying, Diane, I mean, Robert, you see, you were such a big hit in Camelot that maybe the sketch ought to be an English costume play. Now, that would be a good idea. Don't you think so, Diane?
Sorry, I wasn't listening. I was admiring your eyes. They're blue, aren't they?
Yes, they are.
Diane, my eyes are blue, too.
Oh, really? I hadn't noticed. Saying, Mr. Benny. May I call you Jack?
Well, certainly.
Oh, Jack, would you like to order anything?
No. No, thank you.
Let's see what they have.
Bob, you know, I was just thinking about the show again. And instead of doing comedy, being that you're the guest, it might be even a better idea if we devoted the whole half hour to song. Now, that would be a good idea, I think. Don't you?
I dropped my fork.
I'll get it.
Where can I meet you later?
Meet me?
Don't fight it. Look, just give me a little time and I'll get rid of him.
I can't understand it. I mean, Robert is a good-looking fellow, too.
Comparing him to you is like comparing beer to champagne.
Well, I admit I do have a bubbling personality. I never thought of myself as being handsome.
You've never seen yourself through the eyes of a woman in love.
No, I haven't. Oh, no, now please, stop. After all, now, Diane, after all, you came here with Rob.
I know, but I want to leave with you.
Well, let's not be hasty. At least wait until he pays the check.
Anything you say.
Diane, that, call was not for me. It was for you.
Oh. Excuse me.
Jack, that call was not for Diane. I just wanted to take this opportunity to let you know that I have noticed what's been going on at this table. And under it.
You wrote it?
Yes. Yes, now, Jack, please do me a favor. Will you please leave her alone? I mean, to you, she's just a toy, just a plaything. To me, Jack, she is everything. Now, you can get other women. Please, Jack, leave her alone. Please.
They all beg. First it was Valentino and Richard Burton. Now you. Don't sit there whining. If you want the girl, fight for it.
Jack, Jack, I'm no match for you. I know when I'm licked.
Pathetic.
Wasn't for me. What happened to him?
The beer went flat. Here's your wrap, Diane. Let's go. What happened. You know, it's a shame that it had to happen to such a nice guy. But, you know, either you've got it or you haven't. Now, let's see. There was something I wanted to... Oh, Don! Don, come out here a minute, would you please? Don, I asked you to remind me of something. What was it?
Oh, yes. You wanted to tell the audience about your proposed concert tour.
Oh, yes. That's right. Thank you.
Jack, forgive me for interrupting you, but I must go now. And I just wanted to say that it was such a pleasure singing on your show.
Well, it was certainly wonderful having you on the show, and thank you.
It's just amazing that the two of you could come out and work as well as you did after what happened in that restaurant.
Oh, did Jack tell you about the incident?
Not only me. He was telling the audience about it just a moment before you came out.
I'm so embarrassed. Really, I felt terrible about it. If I had known it was going to work out the way it did, I would never have gone over to Jack's table.
You went over to Jack's table?
Nah, what's the difference? He went to my table, I went to his table. Here. Well, thanks again, and good luck.
Wait a minute, Robert. Don't go. I'm interested in this.
Oh, Don. Let him go, will you?
No. Robert, you said you were in the restaurant and you walked over to Jack's table?
Yes, that's right. Jack was sitting at a table with his girl.
Jack was with his girl?
Don, leave him alone, will you? He has to go.
Now, look, Robert. You're sure now? You were in the restaurant, seated all alone.
Yes, I was seated at a table and I happened to be reading a menu when the waiter came over and handed me a note. It was from Jack asking if I would mind dropping over to his table.
Gee, Jack, it certainly was swell of you to bring me here.
I like you.
Uh-huh.
Jack?
Oh, Robert.
I got your note.
Well, good. Now, the reason I asked you to come over... Oh, first I want you to meet Miss... Where'd she go?
I went to get him a chair.
Now, Bob. The reason I asked you to come over is because I wanted to talk to you about being a guest on one of my television shows.
Well, I think that sounds wonderful, Jack.
Was my idea.
Miss
Scott. Diane Scott. You could call me Di.
Now, Robert, I've got a wonderful idea. I got the whole show in mind. Now, naturally, when I first introduce you, before I do, I'll do my usual monologue. I want maybe 2-3 minutes, you see. Then when I introduce you, we'll do talk. A few minutes, you and I. See, then I know they'll want you to sing, so you can sing a couple of songs. And then, being that you were such a big hit in Camelot, you see, we should do a scene, an English costume play or something like that.
Yeah, I like that. I haven't done too many comedy shows, and I think it'd be a nice, very nice change of...
Oh, then I can count on you.
Sure, I'll see why not.
Uh-oh. Jack? What? Well, my fork, it slipped under the table. Did you get it for me?
Well, of course.
Oh, you gorgeous thing, you... You're irresistible. Don't worry about him. I've got my foot on the back of his head.
Morning, stay with CBN Cable for the 700 Club at 10 Eastern, a lively and spontaneous TV magazine. Then at 11:30, it's Another Life, the continuing drama you don't dare miss. Now stay tuned for I Married Joan, coming up next on CBN Cable.